How's it going, Dopamon fans? Rosters for the 2022 NHL All Star Game are being announced today, so I wanted to bring up an idea I've been thinking about for a while, replacing it with a rookie showcase. As NHL fans know, nobody really cares about the All Star Game, even having missed a year. The highlights are cool because there are huge names, but otherwise, the game lacks intensity and defense and motivation to win, so what I'm proposing is an entirely new type of competition that shows showcases rookies. I'm going to go over a few reasons to justify my proposal, breaking down how I think the competition could work out, and then give mock rosters and lines by division for what a rookie showcase in 2022 could look like. But before we do, please leave a comment down below with what changes you think could be made to the All-Star game, and don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to keep up with our dope hockey content. As I mentioned earlier, many NHL stars are not too keen on going to the All-Star game. With the punishment being a measly one game, NHL stars don't have to worry about losing money or their spot on the roster if they miss one. For them, it's more like an extended time off for some R&R rather than a punishment. And frankly, it's rather an embarrassment by the league. Notable examples include Alexander Ovechkin, Sidney Crosby, Jonathan Quick, Jonathan Taves, and even so far back as Nicklas Lidström, Pavel Datsyuk, who have all repeatedly expressed disinterest and been suspended. The one bright spot that has existed, however, are the young stars. Past examples of rookies playing in the All-Star game include Quinn Hughes, Miro Heiskanen, Brock Besser, Patrick Laine, and Austin Matthews, who've not only had a great time, but brought a lot of much-needed attention to the competition. What separates their game from the rest is that they, while they were still fighting to be NHL stars, the older players had nothing to prove. This brings so much more excitement to their games, and fans love it. Another great example is John Scott, who the NHL had to change the All-Star rules for. His electrifying presence made the All-Star game more enjoyable and one of the highest watched in years. While he wasn't exactly a rookie, it goes to show that when players care to be there, fans care to watch. I see many potential options for a rookie showcase, the first being my favorite, rookies. All the Calder candidates, either by division or by conference, into real rookie All-Star teams. Other options could be a U20 tournament or a U22 tournament, but I think those wouldn't have enough skaters. And as well, a U25 tournament, I feel like would have too many skaters and too many options and not be so much about rookies or young stars. If you have an opinion on either of those, it'd be a perfect time to leave a comment about that down below. And of course, the tournament would work exactly like the All-Star Weekend does now. We could have a skills competition one day and then a tournament the next. The format already exists. This competition could even be played at the same time as the All-Star game, as a sort of transition or to see how well it does among us fans. Now I know what you're all thinking. Not every rookie is a star. And yeah, that's a good thing. Not every All-Star from past years have maintained their star status throughout their career either. This rookie showcase is designed to highlight and build hype for rising stars and young players. You're supposed to not know all the names before the competition, but become very familiar with them after. You watch because you have high hopes for your team's rookie, and then you leave with an appreciation for another team's. Now I want to talk about rosters for the 2022 All-Star Game. If I had it my way with rookies in a sort of rookie showcase, I was able to come up with three forward lines and two defensive pairings for every division. Hypothetically, the divisions could be brought together for an East versus West type competition with a more full and competitive roster. I know potentially in the future there may be a lack of goaltenders in one division, so East versus West could make up for that, but it goes to show that there are enough rookies in the NHL for this type of tournament to be exciting. In the Atlantic, you know guys like Lucas Raymond and Anton Lundell got another chance to be in an All-Star game, but a guy like Michael Bunting might not. In the Metro, guys like Connor McMichael and Seth Jarvis will, but maybe a guy like Sebastian Aho wouldn't. In the Central, Bowen Byram and Alex Carrier are going to be future stars, but Logan Brown might not get another chance to be in a type of competition like this. In the Pacific, Trevor Zegras and Arthur Kaliev, they're both going to be stars. But Ryan McLeod, for instance, is a guy that might never get a chance to play in an All-Star game. So there are plenty of players that may ordinarily, while they would never make an All-Star team, they now get a chance to play in a big competition and maybe even get a boost of confidence for themselves when they get back to playing with their team. Thanks so much for watching. I'm going to leave these lines on the screen as the music plays out. Don't forget to leave a comment down below with what ideas you have for the All-Star game, and leave a like and subscribe to keep up with more dope hockey content. Peace.